Thousands of people are gathered in Hyde Park tonight, rallying against government laws they say are killing Sydney's live music industry.
It is being organised by a group called Don't Kill Live Music.
Now, the industry claims it's another nail in the coffin of live music in New South Wales.
It all stems from my love of music.
Ever since I started writing music, that's all I've ever wanted to do.
There's always hope in the music industry.
That's what's going to sustain them.
I love my music.
Back in the 80s, there was numerous venues around Sydney. All hotels virtually had music every night of the week virtually. So there was lots of venues for bands to play, and there were no restrictions on noise and no restrictions on any number of people in the venue virtually. So we had people going out the doors and it was out of control, but it was great.
In any other city, if you want to have a good time and it's 2 a.m, you know a place to go because they have a red light district, they have a place where they put all the clubs, and it's sort of, there's that relationship with the government at the time and the nightlife. Like, well, here there's no compensation that's being made. There's sort of a disconnect between what people want to do and party and what the police think you should do.
But yeah, like when I did come back from living overseas, I noticed that like after you'd go to a gig, it'd be like, what's next? You know, like you'd do something at the Enmore or the Lansdowne or at Oath, and you'd see all these great bands and you just wanted to keep like seeing more music, but you'd be cut off by like 10 or 11.
Like, especially like now with the climate of our government, our state government, it's really hard for a lot of live music, like festivals, promoters, clubs, they've all really been hit hard by legislation and everything like that. So the whole basis, like the whole idea behind this event was that, you know, even in the face of all this overregulation, like Sydney's still kicking on.
Regulation and culture are just inherently tied together. What I think about the regulations and the stuff going on right now is that because of that change, we have to work out new ways to celebrate and be a culture and to celebrate and appreciate live music. If we can't fix it from the top down, then we have to fix it from the bottom up. Treating music like a business and writing and performing is just like any business. Like, the investment period is massive. The project that I'm in currently, I've only been doing for about 2 years, so it's definitely in that investment period. I did a tour in January that was financially viable. I was able to cover my costs, I was able to pay my opening artists fairly. And I was able to pay rent during that time, during that period, and only having put out one EP and only having, you know, under 500 likes on Facebook and Instagram.
That sort of captures the sentiments towards the music scene. It's not really supported here, it's rather discarded. I think Sydney's just becoming a different place.
And a big thank you to Don't Kill Live Music for putting this on tonight. Here's to live music.
Sydney will be a successful place, but for a particular type of musicians. And it's moved away from Newtown now. It's moving towards Marrickville. There's cool warehouse parties there. It's still thriving and surviving, just sort of in an underground life, if you know the people in the scene and you can get involved and part of it.
Now it's more of dance parties, and it's different. The music is evolving or going forward into a new generation. So yeah, no, music is something that lives forever, and you can't define it by an era. In fact, it's probably better now than it's ever been with the recording and the sounds that they have. But as I say, I don't know about live music these days. It seems to be more of a concert venue type situation, whereas in our day it was more of a raw, get together with everybody, where everyone had fun. Six is a New Zealand band that came to Australia. My brother was the lead singer. They were a punk rock band and became very successful in the end with two number ones in Australia and then toured the world. Number one in the 80s. Rock and roll was, Australia was developing in the music industry, and such bands as NXS, Midnight Oil, they all learnt their trade in the venues in Sydney, and the bands just grew and grew because of the music scene in Sydney. So that's where they learnt their trade. There was no police presence. It was a culture of having fun, and everyone had fun.
We have to inspire people to not give up hope and to go and find those cultural avenues in the places that they do exist. And it won't die. It can't die.
I think there's always hope for everything in the world, because young people bring on their feelings and their aspirations in life. There's always hope in the music industry for it to be positive and creative. There's a lot of creative people still in the world. So the more creativity we courage, the better the world becomes.